Greetings to you all! At the end of July, I had an opportunity to be back at Cinelab and witness how the 35mm film print is created. This is a fascinating and complicated process, which unfortunately has become rare after cinemas switched to digital projectors. It is great that there still are companies such as Cinelab that keep this craft alive. Just before I start, I'd like to encourage you to subscribe to Bortech channel. It is very important as your subscriptions are helping me to open doors into exciting places like this photochemical film processing lab. If you would like to support Bortech channel financially, you can use the Super Thanks feature here on YouTube or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. You will find all the useful links in the description down below. Laboratory manager Andy Hudson will explain how the film print creation process starts.
Okay, so we receive the data from the client for the Pacific project. We would then take the raw stock, which in this case we would be using 2254, which is an intermediate stock. It goes off into the dark room where we load the ARRI magazine. The ARRI magazine is then laced through the camera into an empty mag, and then we're able to go to the system here where we can pull in the job and start the recording process. This ARRILASER would do frame by frame copy to the picture negative of the digital file. Once that's done, the negative's been completed, and it can take up to around sort of anywhere between 15 to 20 hours to get a reel done. It then goes off through to negative developing, where that'll be processed through the neg bath.
Last time I was here at Cinelab, Andy explained how the film negative is developed.
So here we have the processor in action. So currently running at around 98 feet a minute. The film is now going through the tanks, going through the pre-bath, which is removing the backing, off through the developer tanks, and into the stop bank and a stop wash. Once we get through to the stop wash, we're then onto the area where we can see the film travelling through the machine. Now this can be, the film is actually developed now, so it can be exposed to light. Off through the different tanks of processing, you've got your bleach wash tank, your fixer tank, your fix wash, and your stabiliser, and then off through the dryer, back over the top, and it's deassembled back into its original camera roll.
Once that's completed, it then goes off into neg assembly, where it will meet the soundtrack. So it'll be married with the soundtrack to make sure that it's in sync. Once them two products are both made up, top and tail leaded and punch hole for sync, they then go into the cleaning room. They get a quick clean and then they go off into the printing room.
If you think that this process looks complicated, wait until you see film printer made by Bell and Howell. John will tell us more about how to handle this beast.
So the first thing that we need to do before we print anything is determine the size of the aperture. Now at the moment, that's exposing the whole width of the 35mm film, which is fine if we're doing film strips or a job that requires the full width of the film, Super 35, but we are printing with a soundtrack, so we need to put the aperture in that is blocking off where the soundtrack would actually be. The soundtrack is actually printed in this gate, so these are the soundtrack lamps. The white one is the digital track, and the red one is the analog track. So the digital track actually gets printed between the perfs on the stock. So if we open that up, and we can also alter the density by turning the voltage up and down, you can see that's getting brighter now, which will make the picture darker. And then if I reduce it, we can turn it down and make it lighter. That's the density of the film. And to control the amount of red, green, and blue light going through, we've got these light valves, obviously controlling the red amount, green amount. So we just turn these up and down. We ascertain, we do a test on the on whatever we're printing, to ascertain what the final printing light's gonna be. So we'd probably do a head end test just to get the grading right. And then when we're happy with it, or the customer's approved it with our ready grading light, and then we just enter those in there before we start. So now we're gonna lace the picture neg up.
Okay, so John's gonna lace in the picture neg. This has to be up to a maximum of 2,000 feet.
So there's our head sink mark.
So the film printer itself is a Model C. It's made by Bell and Howell. I reckon it's around 40 to 50 years old. It's been with us in Cinelab now for 11 years. I reckon that there's probably only one left in working order.
Just make sure the sink mark is right in the gate. That's the kitchen egg. We are actually able to make the DI neg and the sound negs in-house. So I'm going to lace the sound neg up now. So one thing that we do have to do, we're going to lace the stock up after, which is going to go from there, round here, around there and up there. We have to make an adjustment when we do the soundtrack to allow for the lace up of the machine. Otherwise, by the time that picture gets to there, obviously the sound's going to be too late because that picture has already gone. So what we have to do is we have to take the sound neg back to compensate for the lace up. So we've actually got sound leaders printed with a Model C sync mark already done on it, so we don't have to do it for every reel. So the actual sync mark that lines up with that is this one here. But we've got to pull the soundtrack back to allow for the lace up of the stock going from there up to there. So this is a Model C sync mark for this machine.
The 35mm sound negative is created by running sound film stock through a Westrex sound camera, which exposes the soundtrack onto the side of the film, outside the picture area. Kodak 2374 black and white film stock specifically designed for soundtracks is used in this machine. The only sound system still in use is Dolby SRD. Dolby SR refers to the 2.0 stereo mix, and letter D means digital, which is the 5.1 mix. These formats are simultaneously exposed onto the film. The sound negative is then processed in a black and white bath, ready for synchronizing with the picture negative on a printing machine.
There are three different speed settings on here. Because we're printing onto POS stock, that's the fastest speed, 240 feet a minute. It does go at 90 feet a minute, which is what we normally do intermediates at. You know, if we're making an interpos or an interneg, it's a lot slower film stock. So obviously it needs to, the machine needs to go slower to actually get more light through it. And 180 feet, I think we use on our black and white at the moment as well. So these are the digital voltage lamp and the sound voltage lamp. And this is the picture voltage, which we normally run at 75. And when the machine's running, that'll tell you what speed it's running at. And this is the footage counter.
Talking about counters, you can help this video to reach more views by liking it and subscribing to BoardTech channel. Now let's come back to the printing room.
Obviously, this bit would be done in the dark. So this is a stock.
So the positive film stock that John's lacing up at the moment is made by Kodak. Kodak are the only people now that make film stock for the Model C and for printing. It's 2383 stock. It's supplied in 2,000 foot rolls, so you can print anything up to 2,000 feet. Features can vary from 1 to 10 reels. The average one is anything between sort of 7 and 8 reel long feature. If properly laced up in a projector, it can be run, you know, many times without problem, but it just takes one mislace to NG a print and completely, you know, end up in the bin.
So all the film tension is guided by these, so you have to light up all these arrows, which you can actually see in the dark when it's running, to make sure we haven't lost tension anywhere. Right, so we just make sure everything's on the sprockets.
After the film negative, soundtrack negative and positive film stock is laced through the machine, printing process can be started.
So printing speed is 240 feet per minute. Playback speed is 90 feet a minute. So it's roughly 2.5 times the playback speed.
Before cinemas went digital, this kind of machine would have been running all the time and making thousands of copies of the same movie.
It's a continuous contact printer. So there are machines that obviously it just does a frame at a time, and that's called a step printer. Mind you, I mean, it's for stability, but the results of this machine are absolutely unbelievable. I mean, this is probably the most stable machine that I've ever run, I think.
Right. So, Negan pictures run out. Cut the stock, which is that one. And then put that and then that goes off for developing.
Thank you very much, John. I'm sure that there are a lot of people who appreciate your skills. Now Andy will tell what will happen next.
So once a print is created, the reel will then go off to the POS machine. Runs at 100 foot a minute. It's a photomic, so it's more or less exactly the same as our negative processor, but it runs with ECP chemistry, which is Eastman Color POS. We run that mostly in the dark under yellow light. Once that comes off of there, it's read up on a densitometer to make sure that we've met the aims. After the film has been developed, it has to go through a QC stage in our theatre. At Cinelab, we have our own theatre. We use a Kineton projector. On average, you know, 2,000 foot reel takes around 20 minutes to go through the projector. Some examples are that if we're doing a job that could be 11 copies, it would mean that we'd have to watch the reel 1 11 times, the reel 2 11 times, and so on throughout the thing, so we can spend weeks and weeks watching movies in the cinema. We can sit in the theatre and we can monitor and we can check the sound quality and we can check the picture quality and we can make sure everything's ready for shipping to the cinema.
Here you go. You just learned how the movie film print is created. Massive thanks to all Cinelab team who helped me with the production of this video. By the way, there is one more topic that I'd like to cover. Process called DFD, when a movie shot on digital cameras transferred on film, which is later scanned and transferred back to digital domain. It is a very interesting process which is becoming more and more popular. Let me know if you would like to see this kind of video. This is it for this time. Thanks again for watching and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.